I'm doing something a little bit different. Our hobbies, 3D printing, tabletop crafting, painting minis, they're supposed to be fun. But sometimes there's a little bit of an element of risk. I'm going to show you how I installed a ventilation fan in my 3D printer enclosure this week on Short Rest Studios. Hey, I'm Judd. Welcome to another episode of Short Rest Studios. You probably know that 3D printing, especially with resin, which is what we typically use for miniatures, has some inherent health risks. And I want to keep me and my family safe while I'm doing the things that I find enjoyable. So I was looking for an enclosure for my resin printer that was ventilated, and a friend of mine was generous enough to actually give me one. Which you'll see in a photo here, picture from Amazon of the actual enclosure that I have my resin printer in. I also have an Ender 3, a filament printer, which I would really like to ventilate as well because I typically print with PLA because it's pretty much non-toxic. The fumes aren't really anything to worry about, but I want to try some other materials. And so I would like to ventilate that printer as well. A while back, I purchased for that a fire safe enclosure that helps maintain temperature and all that kind of thing inside, but it's just a basic enclosure. It has openings on the sides for ventilation and an opening in the back for power cords, stuff like that, but it's just a basic enclosure that helps it to stay safer, helps it keep the dust off of it, and helps maintain the temperature of the printer. But I needed to ventilate it. So to buy a ventilated enclosure for my Ender 3 was a lot more expensive than the one that I have for my resin printer because it's smaller. And I didn't want to spend that much money. I didn't really want to buy a new enclosure. So I decided to install my own fan. I'm going to put links in the description below to all the products that I bought to do this project, from the fan to power switch to mounting plates, all that stuff, so that you can go out and do this yourself. There are some things I'm not including, like the acrylic that I use for my full mounting plate, things like that, that I just had laying around, hose clamps. I had those already, and so I didn't put those in this list of materials, but those are things that you can easily find at your local big box hardware store. This was a really easy project, took me a couple of hours, cost $120 all told, even including the enclosure, and it was really worth the effort. Let's take a look now at the project. I needed a mounting plate for this whole contraption, so I grabbed a piece of scrap acrylic I had left over from a picture frame project. I marked it at the 6-inch mark, which gave me enough for 2 6-inch square pieces. Once I put it on my miter saw and cut it, I went slowly because I wasn't sure how the acrylic would do in the miter saw. It melted a little bit around the edges, but it cut it just fine. And this is one of the difficulties of using this type of saw as a left-handed person. I bought this hose mount on Amazon. It's actually an auto part. And right now I'm gonna mark 4 holes that I need to screw into it to mount it to this acrylic plate. Now, basically what I had to do is put the fan between the acrylic and this gray hose mount. And these 4 holes will line up and I just screw the whole thing together. So once I mark those 4 holes, then I take the Sharpie and I mark the big center hole, which is about 3 inches. I've got 3-inch vent hoses that I'm gonna connect to it. And you can see there the circles that I've marked, the places that I've marked to cut out. And so now I'm gonna clamp this to a piece of scrap wood so I can drill into it and drill out my 4 screw holes real quick. It wasn't that quick. I edited this in case you can't tell. And here comes the hole saw, causing destruction to materials of all kinds since 1908. I'm kidding, it's probably been a lot longer than that. That's why they have those holes in the side of your hole saw, by the way, so you can pry the material out of there if you didn't know that. So once I finish prying that stuff out of there, I'm just gonna sand down the edges of that hole that I just cut. And I went slow again, and probably even if I hadn't, this would have happened, but the material melted around the cut, which caused it to then solidify, so I had to kind of cut some of that off of there. But I just want to sand it down enough that it doesn't, you know, cut me or something while I'm messing with it, because it doesn't have to be pretty. And now I'm going to break open this inline power switch that
I kind of decided to get last minute because I didn't think about it before, because that's just how I am. So I take the cover off, and then I strip the wires on the end of the power cable that came with the fan that I purchased, because it doesn't come with a power cord attached. So once I stripped the ends of those wires and the ends of the wires that are coming out of the fan, I took one wire from the power cord and one wire from the fan, and I twisted them together. And this particular fan doesn't have positive and negative wires, so it doesn't matter which one you connect to which, as long as you don't cross them. So now I'm going to take the remaining wire from the fan and connect it to the screw connector inside the switch, and then I'm going to do the same thing with the remaining wire from the power cable. You can probably tell it took me a little extra time to get that wire from the power cable connected to the switch, but eventually I'll put a screwdriver to it and screw it down and it'll be in there. And once that's done, then I plug the fan in and test it out and make sure you keep your fingers away from that thing. It didn't hurt, but yeah, I kept hitting myself with the fan blades when I tested it. If you're getting something out of this video, do me a favor, hit that like button down below. It helps other people get to see it, and it lets me know that you really love me. Now don't go anywhere, we're not done yet. What I'm doing now is putting some electrical tape over that spliced together section of wires. And then there's a slot in the enclosure that you kind of have to finagle that set of wires into. And then once I did that, I put the cover on it. And it's good to go. The switch is ready. Very simple, very easy. You just put two screws in, holds the cover on, and it works perfectly. Works beautifully. Super simple. And I just shored up those two flimsy wires going into the switch from the fan with a little bit of electrical tape. And now we're ready to put everything together, but first we have to make sure we know which side of the fan is the intake so that we mount it properly to the plate. And now we're going to start putting this whole thing together. So these are four screws that came with the fan, as well as four nuts that came with the fan. So I just dropped those into the four holes in the hose mount, which line up perfectly with the four holes in the acrylic. They lined up really well with the four holes in the fan, but I was having a hard time getting everything flush. And the reason that I really needed to is because I want to put that screen on the back side of the fan. So I tried screwing them in tight with the screwdriver. I tried squeezing it with a pair of pliers. Finally, I put a clamp on it and I was able to get the screws to protrude far enough to tighten down those nuts. And here's the whole apparatus. I'm stretching out the end of the 3-inch vent hose that's coming from my resin printer enclosure so that it will fit around this Y connector that I printed on my Ender 3. I did not even think about being able to print something like this until late in the process, which is why I bought the hose mount that I used earlier rather than trying to print it. So there you go. But it took a little work to get this hose on here because it was kind of a tight fit, but I eventually got it on, tightened down that hose clamp, and now I get the new hose that's going to be connected to my Ender 3's enclosure. And it's a little bit easier to get on there. So tighten down that clamp. Now I've got both enclosure hoses connected. And I'm going to use some tape. This is aluminum tape, which is great stuff. It sticks really well. Just watch out when you pull the backing off, because it will snap back and curl up on itself and stick together. It's kind of hard to get it apart. Now here's the end of the hose that's going to go out the garage door, and I'm taking the other end of that now and connecting it to the third point on my Y connector. This hose has the flexibility of the simple foil ones, but it also has a PVC lining on the outside, so it's got a little toughness, but also flexibility. And I tighten down that hose clamp and put some tape on it again, and there is the octopus. And now we're going to use some Velcro. Oh. Sorry, hook and loop material. Velcro is a brand name. And what I'm going to do with that is I'm taking the two sides of material, put them together, and taking the backing off of one of those sides. So I'm pressing it onto the inside of the enclosure, making sure it's good and tight all the way around the opening. And you notice the backing is still on the side I'm touching because my fingers aren't sticking to it. And then once I finish that, I'm going to feed the power cable for the fan through that little opening in the back. And then I can remove the backing from the rest of the hook and loop material and take the acrylic plate the fan is mounted to and press that on tightly to the material, and it is now mounted to the inside of the enclosure, and I can easily remove it and put it back if I need to, because Velcro works that way. Sorry, hook and loop. And it's on there. And now I'm going to attach the hose to the hose mount. And you can see I tried to use tape, but the hose mount was so small that the tape didn't really work out. So I used another hose clamp.
Eureka! It works!
Now I can run that 16-foot hose out the garage door and send those fumes out to take over the world.
There you have it. An easy and affordable way to add ventilation to an existing 3D printer enclosure. If you got some value out of this video, if you just liked it, if you enjoy watching me play around with my power tools, if you just like 3D printing and DIY stuff, do me a favor, hit the like button below. It'll help this video get out to a wider audience. And if you have some suggestions, like if there are things you think I could have done better or differently, put that in the comments below. If there are other videos of this kind you would like to see on this channel, put that in the comments. I would love to hear from you. It would mean a lot. In the meantime, thank you for joining me for another episode of Short Rest Studios. I'll see you next time. Do me a big favor and hit that like button below. It hits, gets...